Number 13, Millard Fillmore, Whig, 1850 to 1853, 50 years old, from New York. Unlucky number 13, Millard Fillmore was an accidental president. Some have called him the Gerald Ford of his day. Considered so unremarkable, a Millard Fillmore society used to gather annually at his gravesite to lampoon his forgotten presidency.
He was a rather strong president, considering the fact that he was an accidental president, and those presidents always have a difficult time establishing their mark.
Millard Fillmore hadn't even met Zachary Taylor until after they were elected. Seen as Taylor's opposite, Fillmore was picked merely to balance the ticket geographically and politically. Fillmore was a northerner, an affable man who was always dressed impeccably. He was a bookworm and a hands-off manager. He aimed to please and appease rather than lead.
He was a kind of colorless character who believed in compromise, who deferred to congressional leadership.
According to most observers, bland, friendly, willing to make you feel that you had said something important, and just generally fitting in.
And yet, behind this amiable personality lurked a man with backbone. Bitter at feeling overlooked by Taylor's cabinet, Fillmore fired all of them. Fillmore continued to exert his newfound power by reversing the policy of his predecessor and signing the Compromise of 1850 into law.
Fillmore said, no, I'm in now and I'm going to change the government's policy. Taylor was all wrong about the Compromise of 1850.
Fillmore supported slavery because he believed its abolition would lead to a collapse of the Southern economy.
60% of U.S. exports came out of the cotton states by 1860. So to abolish slavery was to abolish an economic system.
Fillmore also believed that slavery was protected by the Constitution, and that by signing the compromise, he would somehow put the issue to rest forever. What he failed to grasp were the moral consequences, and he blamed abolitionists for making slavery an issue.
He was totally opposed to the abolitionists. He thought they were troublemakers, fanatics.
Fillmore was content with the compromise because he thought it would preserve the status quo. For some, however, it only served to strengthen their resolve against slavery. By supporting the compromise, Fillmore hoped to please everyone, but instead he ended up pleasing no one, including members of his own party. In the election of 1852, the Whigs wouldn't renominate him. So Fillmore went home to Buffalo, leaving behind one of the most forgettable presidencies in American history. 12 presidents were generals before being elected: Washington, Jackson, Harrison, Taylor, Pierce, Johnson, Grant, Hayes, Garfield, Arthur, Ben Harrison, and Eisenhower.